Yo.
Is Matt here?
Yeah.
Matt, is this a round?
Yeah, I'm getting an RFT.
I'm so sorry. He just told me he was in this room. I thought this was a prep room. I'm so sorry.
I mean, yeah, you can prep in here, but I'm going to be having an RFT while you do that.
I'll let you use that.
Okay. So I voted AF. It was a really close debate. I will start on the things that I thought didn't matter, which was the Rickard and a performative argument on Wagner or whatever. Rickard seems like the easiest opportunity for you in the 2NR because the 1AR, I think, misses the boat. Your first argument is very true that the AF answers this as if it's something in the university that the post-Fiat AF offense can solve, but it was about the way the AF frames the role of the judge. And I think this misunderstanding is evidenced by things like the one you're referring to, the teacher in dialogue with students, and the undercommons. It's unclear to me that the debate round is also like producing an undercommons. Maybe that's how the AF is designed, but that's not really the argument the 1AR makes. So I think that the AF is non-responsive, but the 2NR doesn't do a good enough job expanding on this out and developing it into a voting issue. All I have from the 2NR is... the AF assumes oppression is bad, but we should be able to contest what it means. That's bad because it leads to imperialism, which turns the AF. It's a question of framing, which is prior to anything else. So I have a bunch of questions about this. What is imperialism? Why is it bad? Why does it turn the AF? Does it turn the root cause of the AF? Why is this framing first? What is the alternative conception of the role of the judge? Is it nothing? Is that better? Why? What's the uniqueness, essentially? And then I think the AF could do a better job. I mean, the 2NR could do a better job to develop the alt. One option for the 2NR is to describe it as kind of like a floating pick. Like, yeah, we do the F, we solve the F, just don't do the roll of the ballot. And I think that could be more persuasive. In the 1AR, you need to have more offense. If your strategy is primarily no link on this flow, then this CX is really important. You should cite a line in the Rickard card and be like, how does this describe the F? There's no link here to anything that I said. Okay, performative indict on the Wagner card. It's unclear what to do because of this CX exchange where we were like, delete it from the speech doc. So I think the 1AR needs to like first address that. I don't rule it out on that basis though, because I think like just because we agreed that something is not an argument or doesn't have an impact doesn't mean that there couldn't be like some, it couldn't have relevance in other ways, especially if it's like a pre-Fiat criticism. The problem is I think the 2AR argument departs from the 1AR argument too much. The 1AR argument I floated, and maybe it was I was thinking maybe it was even a flowing mistake just because it was so different. The 1AR I have, I'm not saying we should promote diversity and bring people in, but once they're in the academy, they should be able to engage in their struggle and cross-apply my like undercommons type offense. And then the 2AR is all about black trauma and depictions of suffering, which I understood to be the extension of Kelly. I don't understand how that links to this particular card. I called and read the card. I don't see... how it's about depictions of suffering.
Yeah, that's probably what I mean. I meant to say cross-apply to the hate speech stuff.
Yeah.
Without of.
Oh, maybe. Yeah. I mean, I would have had to look at the particular evidence. I'm not sure what one is ceiling. Okay, turns. I don't think any of the turns really turn the AF. The 2NR acknowledges this a little bit. It's a lot of defense and a lot of kind of vanilla stuff about like free speech being bad. Well, not necessarily bad, but not great. But I don't understand in the context of the AF or in the context of seditious speech restrictions why this turns like students' ability to create an undercommons. That explanation is lacking both in the 1C and the 2NR. And I think the AF has one piece of drop offense, which is the Kelly like kind of palliative argument about how we think that speech codes are enough, so we stop larger structural struggles. Okay, so the debate comes down to the NC. And here are some missed opportunities for the neg as well, because I think the AF is really light on this flow. I decided for the AF ultimately on this freedom question, because I think the AF is ahead on the specificity of the group, the people that we're talking about. Like, the neg never really makes a claim about black people or blackened people, whatever the term we want to use is. The neg just says things like, people are free, they can set ends. And I think there's a lot of extension through ink here. And then the B subpoint is that on strength of link, these social death arguments are in the AF, so I think you need to address them in the 1NC or at least like cross-apply or do some comparison between Ferrero, because I think that the AF is already answering arguments much like this, so it's incumbent on the neg to do that work. things for the AF to improve on in this debate, answer more of the NC, and probably turn the NC so it's not no risk. That's tough because you have to get an explanation of what the heck on the lateral will is in cross-sex and all that, but it's doable. B, you should explain the ontological argument a lot better, even if it's dropped. I don't know if Nick Brady is the best card to read on this. I mean, I like the guy. He has judged me in college a few times, but I don't know about this. I didn't call the card, but there has to be, I think, a more like explanatory, like conceptual warrant than just like this example of criminality, which I think is good as an example. It's not good to like defend an entire claim about the ontology of these folks in the United States. Okay, and then one last meta thing for both of you. The framework comparison here is like really weird. It comes down to this real micro issue where I have to apply really my own weighing standards about specificity and strength of link. So do some more, some deeper framework comparison. I think the AF has like a bunch of education game that can just be like used to take out the entirety of the NC since it's like mostly pure moral philosophy. And on the neg, I would like more more line by line of what is supposed to be framework in the AF, because I doubt those cards. You know, some of the cards are very rhetorical, at least what my understanding of the Moten stuff is. So I think it would be easy to line by line and just win a framework debate straight up with more work on the AF.
I have a few questions.
Yeah.
So why doesn't the NC itself do that? I like contextualize why the AC is just like structural lines bad.
This is something else I wanted to mention. I thought you had two good, you have these preempts, the NC co-ops and outweighs the AF AB, and I thought that I didn't have those arguments at least clearly extended in the 2 and R. Why does the NC not do that itself? Well, like, that's pretty obvious. Where does the NC talk about black people? And, like, that's not to say that you, like, must say the buzzword for me to vote on the NC, but that comparison just is not in the NC. There is an AF card that he says critiques the idea of Kantian rationality. Then the next, like, yeah, but Kantian rationality. Then the 1AR says, you drop the card that critiqued what you did. But it's kind of tough for me to see how you are responsive when you just read the thing that and failed to explain why you're version of it was better, or the Brady and social death stuff of the F didn't apply.
Okay. So on the Rigor K, so why doesn't it, like, if I just show how like it turns the F, for example, and its framework, like it's sort of like a prefab application, why isn't that often?
I just don't think there's a warrant why it turns the F. Like, why?
Because like it reinscribes its bad model to B. And it seems like that was conceded from.
Why is it bad?
Z. That's the entire technique.
Yeah, but you just say imperialism. I don't know. I mean, maybe I need to be more familiar with the Rickert scholarship, and then I would understand. I'm not going to hold you to a super high burden of extension here, because he just, like, totally messes it up in the 1AR. But, like, you have to at least say something. The AF has said, like, does the AF claim that it's, like, a good educational project? I mean, maybe, but the AF also has this entire, the whole discussion of cross-sex in the AF is this post-fiat policy of producing undercommons within academia. Which part are you turning? What's the impact of that? I just don't know. Because the AF doesn't extend any offense that's like education-based, right? It extends post-fiat advantages in the 1AR. So Rickert doesn't turn that, so.
Okay.
You just got to walk through the steps here with a little bit more care.
All right, thank you.
I have a quick question. So you
sure.
Said
can you all, like, speech docs, you know, get that going?
It's really quick.
Yeah.
So you said Brady 12 wasn't the best piece of evidence. Was that for the linguistics argument, like the free speech argument? Or were you talking specifically
like,
about the rationale?
So let me see. I was talking about, like, as a warrant for your social death or ontology arguments.
Okay.
I mean, maybe it's good. Maybe you have, like, a good defense of why the particular Anna Brown example is, like, really important. But it seems like you should just read. mean, maybe it's strategic that you don't read a straight up Wilderson card because then people don't read their Wilderson bad stuff, but like, I don't know, I think maybe even like a Hartman might be better.
You just go streaks.
Sure. It was a 28-6, 28-4.
I like a continued poem.